Dear children, good morning and welcome to this class. During these weeks, we were handling our English reader. We have completed the first unit, which consists of two stories and a poem. Now let us deal with English grammar. Today, I am going to take the topic, the active and passive voice. I'm sure you will be happy because we had already learned the basic of this active and passive voice during the last year. Okay, dear children, let us start with a pleasant topic in a pleasant morning. Welcome all of you. Look at the sentences. Ram helps Sita. Sita is helped by Ram. Here, Ram is the subject, helps is the verb, Sita is the object. In the second sentence, Sita is the subject, is helped is the verb, Ram is the object. Both the sentences have the same meaning, but the constructions are different. In the first sentence, the subject, Ram, is the doer of this action. He does something, that is, he helps. The verb that expresses the action done by the subject is said to be in the active voice. The verb that expresses what is done to the subject is said to be in the passive voice. Here we could see some changes done when we compare with the first and the second sentences. See, the rules we should follow when we change active sentence into passive. The first rule, the object of the active voice change into subject in the passive. The subject of the active voice change into the object of the passive voice. Second rule, the number of the verb is changed according to the number of the person of the subject. Next one, the subject of the verb in the active voice is made the object of the verb in the passive voice and is introduced with the preposition by. Today we are going to deal with the simple present tense and the present continuous tense. What are the changes will happen in both tenses? Look at these sentences. He loves me. He writes letters. They play cricket. We buy a cake. Passive voice. I am loved by him. Letters are written by him. Cricket is played by them. A cake is bought by us. Let's see. He loves me. Which is the subject here? He is the subject. Which is the verb? Loves is the verb. Me is the object. Now we already know that. What is the rule? When the active voice change into passive voice, the subject should change into object and the object becomes the subject. Here, he loves me. Change. I, that is the object change into subject in the passive. I am loved by him. Now you just listen. Loves changed into am loved. When the sentence is in simple present, we should use subject plus is or are or am plus verb 3 form of the verb. Here, he loves me. Loves is a simple present. Changed into loved verb 3 Why I used am here? Since it is a simple present, subject is I, we should use am. I am loved by him. The same way, second one. He writes letters. See, he is a subject. Writes is the verb. Letters are object. Object change into subject. Letters. Letters are plural form. So we should use are. Then verb 3 form of writes, written. Letters are written. We should use by form, by him. They play cricket. They is a subject. They play cricket. They is a subject. Play is the verb. Cricket is the object. When we change into passive voice, cricket, the object in the active voice, becomes the subject in the passive. Cricket is played by them. We buy a cake. A cake is bought by us. The form of simple present tense in past active change to passive. Okay. Subject plus is or are or am plus verb 3. Dear children, please write it in your notebook. The form of simple present in active voice. Sorry, passive voice. Subject plus is or are or am plus verb 3. Let's see what is the form of present continuous tense. Let's see another examples. He is playing chess. She is doing her homework. Satish is reading a book. They are building the house. Now, already you know what is the form of the given sentences. Is or are plus ing form of the verb, that is continuous tense. Now, what is the rule of present continuous tense? We change active to passive. The form of passive form in the continuous tense is subject plus is or am plus being plus V3. Once more, subject plus is or are or am plus being plus V3 in passive voice. Okay. Now let us see how to change the given sentences into passive voice. He is playing chess. He is a subject. Is playing is the verb. Chess is the object. Is playing is present continuous tense. How to change the passive form? Chess is this object we know. Object should be in subject in passive voice. Chess is being played by him. Why we should use is there? Because chess is the singular subject. So we should use is. And when the subject is plural, we should use are. Okay. Now, she is doing her homework. Her homework is being done by her. Satish is reading a book. A book is a subject, sorry, object. So, objective should be the subject in the passive. So, a book is being read by Satish. They are building the house. There is a subject. The house is the object. So, object change into subject in the passive. The house is being built by them. Once more, I repeat the form. Subject plus is or am plus being plus verb 3. When we change present continuous tense into passive, the form is once again subject plus is or am plus being plus V3 form of the verb. Is it clear, my dear children? Okay. Dear children, please write down the given examples in your notebook. I will send the rules and some more examples in the group. Please copy it in your notebook. Some exercise part also will be given tomorrow. So do it. If you have any doubt, please call me. Okay, dear children. Thank you. Bye.